In the case against Caylee Anthony, good afternoon. I'm Sion Rhodes. The defense has called three people to the stand this morning. The first, a very familiar face, crime scene investigator Jennifer Welch. The forensic botanist Jane Bach also took the stand. She testified on the leaves and plants found near Caylee's remains. And before the lunch break, the defense's controversial expert, Dr. Eichenblum, gave his testimony. We have team coverage starting with West 2's Amanda Ober live at the West 2 Courthouse Studio. Amanda, let's talk about what we just heard from the prosecution.
Well, Sian, we continue to hear about these discovery issues. Jose Baez now claiming that the state is violating the discovery rules when it comes to this computer CD, this record of computer data from the Anthony's home computer. He's claiming the state did not provide this to him in a timely fashion. The state rebutted that, and that was what was just going on before they went to the lunch break. Also, we're hearing that the state may want to call as a rebuttal witness a former inmate from the Orange County Jail, April Wayland. Apparently, her child died of drowning. A grandparent was involved in calling 911 and trying to do CPR. And it sounds like the state may want to use this witness to imply that Caylee Anthony may have gotten her story, her defense, from this other inmate. Now, earlier today, we also saw one of the defense's forensic experts testify, and we saw the state prosecutor Jeff Ashton do a good job of essentially tearing her testimony apart. Forensic botanist Dr. Jane Bach was called by the defense to share her opinion of what root growth and leaf litter found around Caylee's remains indicate in terms of how long Caylee's body had been in the woods.
Yes, 2 weeks, approximately 2 weeks.
If Caylee's remains had only been in the woods for 2 weeks, that would support the defense's theory that it was placed there by meter reader Roy Kronk shortly before it was found. However, during cross-examination, Jeff Ashton confronted Brock with a discrepancy in her testimony versus her deposition. In her deposition, Brock said she could not form an opinion as to how long the remains were there.
So you're not of the opinion that the body had only been there for 2 weeks, correct?
It's possible.
Okay. It's also possible it was there for a great deal longer than 2 weeks.
Yes.
That answer may have greatly negated the effectiveness of Bach's testimony, but it was her final statement that may have been the most surprising.
A hip bone was buried in 4 inches of what is referred to as muck, which I assume is wet, I assume you would call wet humus. Wouldn't that indicate pretty conclusively that this skull had been there a whole lot longer than 2 weeks?
Or a dog buried it?
I'm sorry, a dog buried it.
They do, as do coyotes. I don't know if you have those here.
No, we're not blessed with coyotes.
And that was the end of that witness's testimony this morning. Now, as we mentioned earlier, a Dr. Eichenblum, who's a DNA expert from the Netherlands, was on the stand for a short period before lunch. He's the witness whose testimony has been very controversial because of these alleged discovery violations. Now, Judge Perry did say that he believes Jose Baez committed a willful violation of discovery rules by not sharing with the state an opinion that Dr. Eichenblum wanted to give regarding the discovery of, or the lack of DNA evidence in the decompositional fluid found in the trunk of Caylee Anthony's car. So the way the judge resolved it, he said that he will allow a Frye hearing on that particular bit of testimony to be scheduled for some night next week after dinner. And then at that point, the judge will determine whether or not Dr. Eichenblum can talk about that lack of DNA evidence. We have our legal analysts here, and we will have much more for you from our Orange County Courthouse studio coming up. So we hope you stay with us. Live outside the courthouse, Amanda Ober, West 2 News.
Amanda, thanks. And there is more of West 2 News at noon coming up, including a check of your forecast. Stay with us.